I'm Brian Westbrook at AWS reInvent 2025 with GeekWire Studios, joined now by Genevieve Chamard, the AWS Global Partnership Executive for Capgemini. And Genevieve, first of all, thank you so much for taking the time to be with here on this busy show floor.
Very busy, and thank you for having me here.
Absolutely. I want to get into the strong industry focus that Capgemini has with AWS. Can you elaborate on this joint partnership with AWS, and really, how are the advancements in industries going?
Absolutely. So since last year, we've taken a dramatic turn with AWS. We're being more intentional around industries, especially around financial services, automotive, aerospace and defense, energy, and public sector. Last year was the first time that we were concentrating so much on those industries, and this year we're doubling down because we see that it's working. The fact that on the Capgemini side, we are so competent and experts in understanding our client needs specific to those industries, and then use the best technologies from AWS in order to answer those needs. One example is that we came here at reInvent and brought the Hero Car, a full-size car that showcases in a very real experience demo how autonomous mobility, what's called ADAS in that sector, as well as software-defined vehicles, so those updates that your car today are able to receive software updates over the air, can be experienced from the comfort of a car, virtual setup and virtual lens, and powered by AWS.
What are some other examples of industries where you've really doubled down on your efforts? You mentioned financial services. Could you give us more examples of where you've seen success in industries and then followed that up with even more development, even more focus?
Absolutely. So financial services is a sector where we've been traditionally very successful in the, core modernization, infrastructure modernization side. So it was natural for us, since we have such an install base of customers, to double down in, and so much so that we've also seen a lot of demands from line of business. So another solutions that we've been focusing on recently is really like around retail banking, for example, on how we revolutionize together the way we can make payments. So an interesting tech that we took to reInvent this year was to showcase how you can make a payment with just a smile. And we had a lot of customers coming into our experience lounge and trying to trick the system and, for example, stopping to smile and so on, and the transaction doesn't go through.
Did anyone trick the system?
No.
I should give that a try.
You should, absolutely.
That's fantastic, but that's a great example of how customer convenience and technology can converge. Another example of how technology can help improve our lives, generative AI, obviously a big buzzword, a big industry. GSIs such as Capgemini are at the forefront of that. Could you give us some examples of how you're using Gen AI to move the customer experience forward?
Absolutely, and before I answer your question, I want to make a point that not only Gen AI, Agentic AI, is really transforming and disrupting our customers, it's also disrupting us.
Yes.
And it's making, and we actually like internalizing those AI tools and innovation to transform our business and how we serve our clients. So back to your questions around an example of how our customers, our clients use generative AI, agentic AI at scale. For example, we had a customer that we actually have here. What we helped them do is that they wanted to improve the customer experience with the use of agentic AI at a way that they can be more productive and have better automation. We created a full experience on AWS solutions, and the result was a 30% improvement in throughput. So someone may think that, all right, now we have digital workers, so to speak, or AI agents that do the work of individuals. Does it mean that we're gonna now making cuts at this company? But the way we advise them to think about it is that now if you can improve your throughput by 30%, it means that you can actually enable more experience by freeing up your people to focus on other areas, so that they're able to attack other parts of the customer experience. That gain in efficiencies and, of course, in cost savings.
And certainly, if they have 30% additional bandwidth, they can spend more time with the customers that maybe agentic AI is either not ready for or not capable of engaging with.
Yes.
Have you seen customer sat scores go up as a result of this?
We absolutely seen that. We've seen early results, especially the fact that, to your point, we kind of automating the more baseline, repeatable parts of the operations of business processes. And now we can have, we invest also a lot in retraining our the customer workforce in order to go after the value add conversations.
I know you're real busy and you've got a lot to get to, but before I let you go, I want to talk about your partnership and your expansion into Middle East and European sovereign cloud. A big area for you, an area of growth. What's happening there?
Absolutely. So Capgemini being headquartered in Europe, we have a natural fit into those type of expansion. We also are very close across the European countries to public sector entities, so we understand the needs that they have. And with what AWS is about to launch in January around sovereign clouds, we have demands from Germany institutions as well as Netherlands and so on all across Europe that feels that those type of solutions will answer your need, not only from a public sector perspective, but also companies in aerospace and defense, in energy and utility, in telco, in financial services, all of those regulated industries that are looking for solutions a little bit more sovereign. So what we've seen with AWS is that their expansion needs in sovereign clouds or Middle East is actually lining up very well with also our roadmap to get into those areas.
I love it when those synergies combine and dual efforts can really work together. Genevieve, thank you so much for the time. Genevieve Chamard, she is the AWS Global Partnership Executive with Capgemini. I'm Brian Westbrook, GeekWire Studios.